Shalom, Israel. I want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushua. Double honors to the apostles and elders of GMS. And salutations to your brothers out there pushing this word in truth and sincerity. And I want to get into a quick lesson on vitamin D, on how it's essential for the body. And the best source of vitamin D that we can get is from the sun. For us living on this Western Hemisphere, it's kind of hard for us to get the adequate amount of vitamin D due to the fact that this outside of the earth, you know, like us being on top of the equator, only time that we get it is about 3 months out of the year during summertime. And living inside this captivity, we at work from 3 to 11 or 9 to 5 and things like that. So by the time we do get home, it's dark time and shit like that. It still might be hot though, but we ain't really getting that sun exposure. But the Lord made the world for our sake, and he also made the sun, the stars, and the moon for seasons and signs. But another reason why he had made the sun is to give us vitamin D, you know? But in the book of Genesis, it speaks about how the Lord made two great lights. Genesis chapter 1, verse 16, and the Lord made two great lights. The greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. So good sun exposure. I'm not saying go out there and wear, you know, with your titties out, things like that. You know, I'm saying like go out there and just go get the sun. You know, like for brothers and things like that that's into sports, instead of doing it indoors, do it outdoors. You exercise indoors, go out, do it outdoors. Run in the park. If you are like into basketball or whatever like that, get a little shirts and skins going on, you know? Get that good sun exposure. But, like if you don't really get the vitamin D3 from the sunlight, don't go to them GNC shops and try to get it from there. Because most of the time they got it filled up with animal products. A lot of them are GNC pills that have vitamin D3. It's going to be vitamin D3. But it's like from fatty fishes like salmon, mackerel, you know, things like that. Now me, I'm a vegan, so I don't really consume that stuff. And then most of the stuff that you might get, and you might think that it's vitamins, your body can't really absorb it. You know, it's not bioavailable for your body, you know. But if you into herbs or whatever like that, I advise you getting it from an herb called dandelion, which is very high in vitamin D. There's many other nutrients inside dandelion, but it's also high in vitamin D. Moringa. Four leaves of a moringa plant is 17. It gives you 17 times more vitamin D than milk, man. That's very heavy right there. So the Lord made it possible that if you don't get the adequate amount of vitamin D, you can get it from the herbs, you know. But, you know, if you ever wanted to get your vitamin D levels checked, you would need to go to a doctor, and he had to take your blood just to check your vitamin D levels. But it's a couple signs and symptoms that I'm going to give you to let you know if you're vitamin D deficient, you know. But, quick though, you know, like Israel coming different shades of brown or whatever like that, you know. And, like it might be harmful to certain brothers. So for sunscreen, an alternative to sunscreen, I advise you using a coconut oil, mix that with some neem oil. It's a plant called neem, N-E-E-M. Mix that right there with some shea butter. So coconut oil, shea butter, and neem oil is an alternative to sunscreen lotion, you know? And then you could drop your top of your car. This is a Google Images right here. I think they got a joint in their hand. Issacharites. You know, I mean, they're going off, but if you're driving your car, drop your top, you know? Drop your top and get that sun exposure, you know? Right here, you got the chemtrails in the back or whatever like that. But, like, with vitamin D, you can't really OD on vitamin D. You can get a lot of vitamin D, you know? In fact, all the vitamin D that your body is not using, it is stored inside your fat cells, and then it'll use it when you're in need of it. But I'm going to get into a few of the, you know, the signs and symptoms that you're vitamin D deficient. And one of them is osteoporosis, which is a bone disease. Another one is rickets, which is, like, say, for instance, right, or you see a girl, she bow-legged, you might first think she got a nice ass walk, man. No, she's vitamin D deficient. That bow leg sign, that's a sign that she's vitamin D deficient, celiacia. Like a weak immune system. Every other season when you're catching a cold or a flu, that's a sign that you're vitamin D deficient. Having asthma is a sign that you're vitamin D deficient. Tuberculosis, diabetes, a lot of blood, irregulated, like disorders is showing that you're vitamin D deficient. Periodontal diseases, you know, like teeth diseases, you know, like dealing like with your gums and your teeth. Cardiovascular diseases, high blood pressure, CHF, which is congestive heart failure. All that right there shows, and it's a sign that you might be vitamin D deficient. You know, mood or depressions. You know, multiple sclerosis and all forms of cancer stems from being vitamin D deficient, you know. So vitamin D, man, like, is a real essential, like, for your body, you know. You can kill a lot of, well, you can prevent a lot of stuff by having vitamin D in you. For instance, there's one dude that I know. He's like, yo, man, every morning when I wake up, my body aching, man. Body aching. I'm like, shit, man, what you doing last night, man? He's like, yo, listen, bro, I don't work out, none of that, man. My body just aching. Went to the doctor, found out he vitamin D deficient. So really, it deals like with your bones too, man. It deals like with your bones, your immune system, and everything. You can end up getting sick quicker just because you don't have a lot of vitamin D in you. You know? But I'm about to end it off real quick with a quick scripture in the book of Ecclesiastes. You know, let me find it. Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 7. Truly delight is sweet, and a pleasant thing it is for the eyes to behold the sun. And right, it is a pleasant thing for the eyes to behold the sun, you know. So when shades and things like that, man, that's going off, man. You know, ISUPK, they are kind of camp wearing dark shades and things like that. They ain't getting no vitamin D, man. So if you brothers think about wearing shades and things like that, or wearing, you know, like them bucket hats to block yourself from the sun, or even having an umbrella on during the summertime and going off, you prevent yourself from getting vitamin D, man. So, in conclusion, I advise you brothers to go out there and get that sunshine, man. Get that sunlight. The Lord made it. Shit, that's how the trees and things grow, you know? It's a balance with everything. But once you have a melanin, you ain't really going to do no damage to yourself, man. You know, because for one man, you're only getting it 3 months out of the year living on this hemisphere. So if you're on vacation, you know, don't put on no goddamn Speedos and shit, man, looking like you Prince. You know, expose your flesh a little bit and get yourself some vitamin D, man. You know? And with that, I want to give all praise and glory to Yahweh Shem Yahushua. Double honors to the apostles and elders of GMS. Salutations to you brothers out there, man. And if I haven't hit every point, Lord willing, in the future, I'll hit that soon. But in the meantime, man, get that sunlight. And the sun is not your enemy, man. With that, Shalom.